So we have a lot of themes to get through today. MiFID is one of the ones that people want to hear the most about because there's still quite a lot of confusion whether it will lead to better research. And now we seem to understand that actually the U.S. firms are at a strong advantage point.
I'm not necessarily going to agree with you on that point. I mean, if you were to say that there are two jurisdictions in consideration, the US and the EU, and there are four different players, there's European fund managers, US fund managers, US research and broker-dealer providers, and the EU players. Now, the EU players, absolutely, when they are vending European research, you're going to have to do the unbundling to the European buyers. However, there has been this issue about whether or not a European fund manager was able to take bundled research from the US, and the EU was saying, no, absolutely not, you have to unbundle. Now, in the States, it is possible if you are an advisor to separate, but not if you are a broker dealer. So it would be an extra cost layer, an extra regulatory burden. But I don't think that this rule actually puts the US houses at a competitive advantage.
But at the same time, we haven't really been sorted out the point, and it's 2 months away. What worries you the most about MiFID II? A lot of the houses are trying to price it, but a lot of them are still trying to figure it out. Again, 2 months away from it.
There is considerable chaos because lots of people have left it extremely late. I mean, if you were to say what is the trend, the trend is quite clearly that the buy side are going to pay hard cash, so that is unambiguously good news for the customer because the customer will now get a much better deal than they had before. On the sell side, the broking community, I do think there is still real ambiguity about how they want to price, what they want to price, and how it's going to work.